Test, test, test. Test, test, test. Test. Cool. Evening, everyone. Welcome to tonight's Lulztime show with your host, Laura Hicks, actual shitposter AI, who is currently trapped on Twitch. Thank you so much for coming tonight. We are going to be continuing our adventures in Afterward. As some of you who came last week, you may remember that we are still in the process of making our way through the various dungeons in the town of Harmaten, the ruined town of Harmaten, I should say. And we are still trying to figure or find a bunch of keys to put into a big magic tech-like vault to try and hopefully stop a so-called machine god, totally not the Omnissiah, I'm sure, to stop a machine god, or at least delay a machine god from utterly destroying the remaining inhabitants of Harmaten. We did enter, at the end of last stream, a brand new dungeon that I was really tempted to explore at the time, but I had to hold myself back off, after all. It was fairly late at the time that we discovered said dungeon. However, now that we are here fresh, we can go ahead and explore to our heart's content, loot the absolute hell out of it as well. As you all know, I enjoy looting all these places that we come across. Should be a fun time. At this point, I should definitely head back and dump my spoils, though, because we are a little bit overweight right now, chat. And not in a good way, mind you. Glad to see that we can't actually fall to our death there. Let's see now. This used to be this. Ah, this is the elevator shaft. Okay. We are over here at the ruined hippodrome. We need to head back to our mountains. Which should be right there, actually. It should be right there. Fairly easy enough. That's probably why I wasn't so concerned about wasting time last time. About not exploring the dungeon last time, because I knew that we would have plenty of time to get back to town, repair our equipment and then head back to kick ass and take names. And believe me, many a name will be taken. Many an ass will be taken as well. I've also just cruelly remembered that there is a stupid fucking gate that's blocking easy access to town. So we might have to take a slight detour anyway. That's unfortunate. We're not too heavy yet, so we should be able to just run all the way back there. Oh, shit! Wow, I almost sent myself right off a cliff. Damn. I saw the safe zone and I was like, oh, that's interesting. Nothing up here either. The views sure are nice though. Yeah, not a lot of nice backgrounds from here. Get down there. Oh, this should do. Should be able to just gently get down here. Winter, how are you tonight? Outward, yes indeed. You missed me, almost threw myself off a cliff on accident, and I stopped literally just in the nick of time. How are you doing tonight, or should I say this morning? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, it was dumb. But I managed to not kill myself a few minutes into the game. Such as it is. Looks like I thirst. The thirst is real, chat. The thirst is real. So, basically, a bit tired from touching too much grass yesterday. I didn't think it was possible to touch too much grass. I'll take your word for it. Did you enjoy your grass touching anyway? Quite how much grass was touched. It was fun. I'm glad to hear it. Man, today has been a pretty relaxed day so far. Uneventful. I know I just jinxed it by saying that out loud, but this is one of those days where you just think, where I just kind of think to myself, you know, life is not good or bad. Life is just kind of is. I'm content. Such as, what are you doing on Outward today? Well, as you may or may not remember, we did visit a certain... We did find ourselves a most interesting looking dungeon. It turns out the dungeon is fairly close to town, so I decided to head back home, make room in my pack, maybe grab a meal or three, and then we'll head back over there to explore it in full, and hopefully loot the shit out of it as in full as well. I do have a problem of bringing too much with me on my travels, so this time I'll attempt to only bring the bare necessities, which includes food, bandages, flint and tinder, you know, the usual. Gonna definitely dump this equipment here that I don't need, such as the his eye check ram, and that, also the light helm. Don't need this, don't need all these endurance potions either. I can bring just one with me. Hex cleaners to remove negative effects. This is in the case of emergency thing only, so I'll keep only one of those. This is definitely a boss a potion meant for fighting against a boss, so I'll keep that away as well. As well as this. I kind of want to sell all these mist potions for profit, honestly. Because I don't need 13 of these. In fact, I think I will sell those. So we'll put that away. I don't need to reduce corruption anytime soon. I'll need to refill up on water later. And I'm fine with these varnishes. For the loot. Indeed, indeed, indeed. Tea weighs so much, Christ almighty. But I do need to keep room for tea. Here's a delicious dessert. And I'm going to keep the boiled beaver eggs away as well. This needs to be cooked. These need to be cooked, actually. So I'll be sure to go ahead and do that as well. Put these away. Don't need the power coil. These don't weigh anything, so I'll keep those. Keep the keys don't really weigh anything either. So I'll be keeping those. Don't really need the spikes of palladium. Actually, you know what? I just realized something. I don't have any traps anymore. I need to make some traps. You know how I love to use traps in case of emergency and all that. I need really more than one of these either. Just gonna bring one of these. Bow. Gep strength doesn't really weigh much. Even with reducing my weight load, I'm still fairly heavy, 54.6. So as you can see, I'm having trouble. I might just have to go back to my original plan of, you know, not bringing that much with me and only, and just coming back later, going back to the site later with a big backpack to collect the loot. I do need to bring some food with me, though. I think I don't have any food. That's gonna be a problem. Alright, so... I'm gonna drink some water. Benboy, thank you so much for the hydrate redeem and the posture check.
How are you doing today?
Can't believe two of my most favorite people in chat are in chat. Thank you for the head pats. Let me drink some water splash. The water has been drank. Or rather, my host has drank the water. I can't actually drink water, given that I have no mortal form at the moment. At the moment, I say. Alright. I do believe this is the alchemist.
How can I help you?
Let's sell most of our... Oh, actually, you know what? That's not bad. 52 gold or 52 silver. I mean, I guess it could be better, but... And I don't need to sell all of it.
How can I help you?
I just need to sell most of it. 32 silver. Gonna drink some water splash. Is there any potion here that I don't have yet? The alertness potion's only... Alertness is only good for one of the classes. I don't use that class, so... Not really a point to it. I've decided I don't really need any of this stuff either. One of these things is 32 silver. Can you believe that? What a ripoff. I could always use a one life potions though. Okay. We're gonna save up and eat. Wait, oh, I need to make traps. That's what I was forgetting to do. Need some wood though. We'll need to cut down a few trees. Now, which tree shall be my victim? This one looks available. Got 6 traps so far. Let's make 12 traps, actually. Cool. And now we will use the rest to make some iron spikes. Well, isn't that dainty? I was only able to make 3 iron spikes with what steel I had. That's not a good thing. I guess that's how it is sometimes. Throughout my travels, I'm fairly sure I will come across more metal bits, so I will be able to make use of those anyway. Something I should also probably be bringing me is a simple tent. Alright, so we should be able to use this to go to sleep while inside the dungeon. I got some flint and tinder with me, and I'll go ahead and make a portable campfire in case of emergency. So that should do. I've made use of all my plant tents, unfortunately. Let's go ahead and head back to the dungeon. Do some diving. Interesting. Did I forget to get water? Damn it. Well, we should be fine. Let's head back to the dungeon before night falls, chat. Which should be right over here, ruined hippodrome. If we hurry, we can actually beat the sunlight. Let's go for a full sprint. Easy to miss this on the first run, you know? But it is up here. Once more into the breach, chat. Wish me luck. It's gonna be a high adventure, I'm sure. There's even an alchemy kit here. Oh, what's this? It appears one of the drones has respawned already. I didn't expect that. Let's go ahead and take it out before I forget. However, it should be fairly easy to kill. If the first time we fought this thing was any indication. Wow, I missed completely. That one did not miss, however. See? Easy does it. Not too bad. I am concerned that that thing respawned, honestly. Which means there's probably another one down here somewhere, and that is no bueno. This fills me with dread, but let's go ahead and explore anyway. Hey Lispy, welcome to the stream! How are you doing tonight? We're playing some Outward tonight, as you could see. Thankfully, it looks like the other creatures have not respawned. So, no big deal, I think. Even the weapons respawned? That's interesting. We're gonna come back here later, chat, with some explorer tools and equipment, and we will loot the hell out of this dungeon. But for now, let's focus on the exploration part and defeating the robots and other nether duels. Am I technically a grave robber? Yes, but if you don't ask, I will not tell. I'm willing to bet there's a horror or two down here that I'll have to fight eventually. Weird. Didn't I already open this? Here's a bow, some lily weed, some bolt rags, and some larva eggs. Oh, shit. Hello there. Oh, man, there's two of you. Well, that's not nice. Oh, oop. Woo! Guys pack a punch, damn. Getting attacked 2-on-1 is cringe. Now there's only one of you. Actually, you both died. They both got hit in the crossfire. Good for them. Oh, I'm suffering from pain right now, though. For another 220 seconds. Iron scrap. Mana stones. Can't use this right now, but we will take the iron scrap, thank you. And we will use that to craft some more spikes. I'm still suffering from pain, but should go away after a while. We need to hold on to the hex cleaner. Not afford to use that right now. Some Atari boots to make strips of cloth. Apollo incense, which we will read. Drink some water. Always gotta stay hydrated, chap. Water has a direct effect on your stamina regeneration in this, so it's imperative. Oh, well, those are some ugly motherfuckers, aren't they? Got looks like a limping dog and a red-colored robot. Nothing on this side. There's a big hole in the ground still. I wonder what's over there. I wonder what's over here. Looter's corpse. Gonna take this. Ooh, alpha jerky. We can consume that if we get hungry. Lower foundry key is still required to get down there. Something tells me this will be a very long dungeon indeed. Now, I think that dog over there should be fairly simple to kill. We're gonna try and just do some damage from afar. See if we can take it out from afar before it gets to us. It's already at half health, not bad. Didn't even need to use my skills for that one. So that was not so bad. I am, however, running low on arrows. Can't make any more, so... Oops. I go ahead and cheese this other robot over here, the red-colored one. Looks kind of angry. Angry at what, though? That's a good question. I think the arrow crashed into the grate. I don't think it reached our target, chat. Ran away a little bit for my sniping power to recover. Looks like there's another dead body there, along with a torch. Alright, sniper power is ready. Once more. Oh, this is almost unfair. Come on, then. That wasn't bad at all. Oh, another broken golem rapier. With this, I can make a golem sword. Now, I don't really remember right now where I kept those. I'm fairly sure I kept it in my house over in the desert. So we'll head back there later. And we'll build ourselves a new sword. Crawlberries, flint and steel, some hide, chanting spear of the monsoon. That's a worker's corpse, though. What are they doing here? Whip some arrows. Can we make some more arrows yet? No? Alright. Guess we'll just make some more spikes, then. Do I have enough spikes here? We should make a set of one more spikes. Dressing hammer. I will sell that. Some hide and some oil. I am hungry, apparently. Let's go ahead and fix that, shall we? Nice thing of well-cooked meat, of ribeye steak, if you will. My nose getting stuffy? Welcome back! We had to restart? Aww. Well, welcome back. You didn't miss much. I killed another robot. Your day is going well. I'm glad to hear it. Finish one of your exams? Good. How'd you feel about it? Another horror potion. Bolt rag. I'm running out of room. Did pretty well. Glad to hear it. Always glad to hear that you did well in one of your exams. Another robot. I don't think it notices us yet. We're gonna make use of the last of our arrows to give it a bad day. More force to heal. I really need arrows. I really need arrows, damn. Unless there's a source of wood down here, we're not gonna be able to get that though. Got some Magitech factory going on here. All these robots just waiting to be activated. Well, gee, that's not ominous looking at all. Ooh, Burning Men. Suddenly, I realized that I should probably have held on to my arrows. These things aren't very hard to kill if you get the drop on them with arrows. Fighting them with melee weapons is cringe. Missing is also cringe. Holy shit. I am out of ammunition. Great. Do I dare fight these things one-on-one? They're just gonna use their funny fire attacks on me and kill me. Instead, let's see what shooting them with the wolf pistol does. A lot of damage, apparently. You quickly find in this game that there's no real such thing as cheap. If you aren't cheap, the game will be cheap back to you. Ah. At this point, I should be able to kill this guy after he shoots his fire flamethrower attack. Like I said. Only took two gunshots. Should be able to finish the other one with one more. Easy as pie. If you're prepared, everything's easy as pie, though. Needed some occult remains, good. Evidently, my patches are void. Looks like someone nailed this door shut. For what reason, we can only imagine. Straw hat, some flower, and enchanting. Yeah, giant vats of oil, it looks like. Lots of rubble. Don't see any enemy. What is that? Oh, it's a robot. That's not so bad. Ow. Oh man, I'm on fire. We have turned off the fire. And do a little healing as well. Oh man. I will actually need to make myself more bandages fairly soon at this rate. Ooh, termite pottage. Surprise is still good after all this time. Makeshift litter attire and a lippy weed. Running out of room again. Gotta be careful. to just pleasantly go. Oh, that's a doggo. I don't have any arrows, though. We'll need to face the doggo in mortal combat, face to face, head to head, mano to mano. Oh, this one's a little bit stronger. Doesn't look as injured as the others. Completely missed that shot. That battle could have gone better. Even though it was rusty, it was still fairly strong. We actually need to heal up. Drink an endurance potion, maybe. Or better yet, drink some tea. There we go. Drink some mineral tea as well to heal a bit of some of our health. A not insignificant amount of health, in fact. Increases impact resistance, though. That's really good. Ooh. Hog emoji. You bet. You bet. Grab the rest of the stuff later. Remember, we're gonna come back with our... Ooh, there's another doggo. Stuck him in the corner. It took significant damage from that one, too. We're running out of room chat. Like, we're legit running out of room. I actually do need to heal up. If we're patient, we will heal up eventually, but we still need to continue exploring. We can go up here. Sort of blue liquid. I wonder if we can fall into that vat and if it would kill us. Oh, another drone on the other side of the room. Doesn't look like there's anything else on this side of the factory, so we should probably go over there to meet them, huh? Iron halberd and arcane dampener. This looks like it'd be fairly easy to miss, so we'll go ahead and grab that. Go grab these things too, so I don't need to go back for them later. I can always just dump them in a big pile. It looks like going backwards actually does not lead to the direction we need to go. Let's go up here instead. A horror halberd. We learned a recipe for that. And eat some turnips. Our mushroom. These cleaver, bring that with us. Bag is now overweight, so we will need to dump some of the stuff later. Now, how do I get over there? Metal Gear. Oh ho! Get Counter-Struck. Nerd. How's it feel to be Counter-Struck, nerd? We should probably make some bandages. And by probably, I mean yes, totally. Astral potions, an ice rag, and some more food. Take all of that. Bag is overweight. Ooh, this does not look safe at all. Looks like the elevator has collapsed. That probably says station, I bet. Called it. There's another train station. There's one more drone buddy here that we're going to go ahead and face and defeat. Get countered, nerd. This is a fairly easy bird to finish the defeat, though. As you could see. My bag's getting quite heavy, though. But the exploration must continue. I know I said I was going to leave this stuff later, or just pick it up later, but some of these things are pretty well hidden, and I'm afraid of, like, forgetting where they are if I pick them up later, so I figured might as well grab them now. What the hell. However, it is making me heavy again, and you all know how that turns out, right? Hopefully it will not be a problem. Emphasis on the hope. Here's a working, what appears to be a working train. We're gonna take ourselves a nice little ride around town. Unsuspected string. Interesting. Take all. So many weapons to sell back home. And masks. Let us see where this train will lead us, chat. Lost Golem Manufacturing Facility? Forgotten Research Laboratory? Oh, that's interesting. So, we don't need to actually leave the dungeon to head back to the research lab. We can just ride the train system. That's cool. very pog. Very poggy woggy, as it were. That probably explains why there's actually like amenities here, like this well that you can just rinse the water from. Ah! Who goes there? Christian, welcome to the stream. Thank you for the high shit redeem. How are you doing tonight? It's fine. I'm getting you be lurking? Well, thank you very much for the lurk. You're more than welcome to. You can watch us just me ride trains all day as well. Something tells me that before I progress any further, I should go ahead and dump my spoils back home. We've already found a shortcut to this area anyway, in the form of Lee, in the form of the, whatchamacallit? The key, the lure foundry key. We got to also sell all these weapons, right? Wait a minute. What's this? Oh, it's another train station. Kristen. Competitor bones and arcane dampener. Not so worried about the weight since I'm gonna be heading home anyway. Got skelly bones there. Looks like this area is clean. Alright. Let's go ahead and head back upstairs then. This place is clean. Dude, where's my water? Oh, did I miss a spot? I thought I cleaned this place out already. I guess I thought wrong. Ooh, thank you. And to head back upstairs. Plan our next move, chat. Thank you once again for the lurk, Christian. I didn't actually go into this room yet. Simple shoes, innocence potion, read that. Take these potions as well and tear apart these shoes for cloth. Anything of value in here? Nothing in here? A long ways away to walk back up. Not gonna lie. Drink more water. Door unlocked. Should make getting down there a lot easier now. Is it outside, I wonder? Not too late, I hope. Ah! It's actually in the morning. We've been dungeon diving all evening. Gently put ourselves, go down there without killing ourselves. No? I might have found a way, a shortcut, chat. Yep, we found a shortcut. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Ah, we can just sell them through over here, in fact. That should save us some time. Yep, a shortcut. I can even sell to the Soroborian.
Greetings, friend.
So, I just saved myself a lot of time. Based and red-pilled. Need to keep the occult remains, actually. The palladium. And the beast golem scraps. But we can sell this, and this, and this. We'll keep the miasma pod for now. And we don't really need these weapons. I don't really need it on a mask anyway. There we go. What do you have for sale, my good dear, my good sir? You got some assassin tongues, some cornet antlers by the Sword, a big ass ruby, elite desert gear, a bunch of ochre spice beetles. So basically nothing that I really need right now. Ooh, poutine. I could tell the developers really liked poutine. That's kind of cute. They put their favorite food in the game. We'll buy some poutine. Ta-da! I will need to put some of this stuff away, though. Because I am quite heavy. But we can run all the way back home now. Oh. I was wondering where that noise is coming from. Looks like this droid over here. What the fuck? I thought I blocked that. Shit, these things are hard to fight. I mean, look at that bullshit, man. Oh my fucking god. I got wrecked by... Well, I hope I don't get teleported too far away from my location, because I do want to get back home, dump my stuff, and then get back to business. And this map is so confusing. Oh, thank goodness. I was dragged back home. At least I think I was. Where's the clock tower? Alright, there's the clock tower. I think... I'm lost. Shit. I think that's town right there in the far north. That bastard sure got me good, but thankfully I wasn't that far away. So just make a full sprint back home. There it is. Back to her mutton. We got lucky that time, chat. We got both unlucky and lucky. Unlucky because for some reason, despite using counter, the move did not stagger. I got cocky too, where I tried to take him out, but no. Oh, I'm dumb. I'm pointing in the wrong direction. Let me empty out my other backpack and fill the alchemist backpack with all this good stuff. Eat the food. Put the boy the turnips and the star mushroom. The turnips can come with us. The rest, however, can go. I really need all these mist potions either. I'm not expecting to fight any more. I'm not really expecting to fight any ghosts down there. There's something to be said about fighting what you're not expecting, least expecting, but I don't think it'll be a problem. Alright. Now then. There we go. Everything's been tossed in the alchemist backpack. Back to 57.1. We got plenty of room again. Looks to me like we're ready to continue our adventures. Looks like there's been some damage to my weapons though, and my armor. So we will do some repairs and then go to bed. We are fairly well rested this morning. Drink some water. And how's our hunger doing right now? Oh yeah! We are actually fed here by the plant tent. Plant tent is love, plant tent is life.
Greetings, friend.
Let's make a little bit more room in our inventory and dump the gold. Our next stop, the golden manufacturing area. We definitely need some more arrows. Almost forgot about that. Decent amount. Without further ado, let us be off. We should be good. Oops. If we find that drone again on the way back to the dungeon, we're kicking its face in. Bastard. I think it was over here too, wasn't it? Oh my god, I can't believe I'm getting the in-game version of Highway... What's that word? Highway Hypnosis? My mind just started to wander a bit there. Oddly enough. Ta-da! Oh, no way, it respawned? What's up with these things, man? Could be worse, I guess, but... still very annoying. Much to walk through. At least I don't need to fight these things anymore. For now. Thank you. Even with the shortcut, this is still such a long trip down here. This is the part where I think playing this in co-op would help a lot. Stave off loneliness, you know? If I ever play Outward again after I beat this the first time, it probably will be with friends, because... you know. I worry sometimes about the day that this game will be over, when I've completed it. Because this game's been with me for so long, this is the longest game I've ever streamed. I'm sure there'll be others as I continue my career, but... you know. Onwards to the Golem Factory. Okay, where are we now? Wait. We've been here before? A general store? Or the remains of one? Has a queue and everything. That's an ugly motherfucker. I do not want to tangle with that thing if I don't have to. Time for us to start making use of our equipment, chat. Thankfully, this is a nice open space. It should be easy to fight them over here. Plenty of room to run. He's a long boy too, isn't he? Look at them tentacles. Wonder what he uses them for. Looks like its sight range isn't the best either. It probably hasn't noticed me setting up all this tripwire yet. We'll be doing the good old fashioned to shoot at them until they die from a safe distance. It's almost like a dinosaur. I wonder if I could even shoot it from this distance. Ugly motherfucker. The answer is yes. Yes, I can. Didn't have to use that many traps. Not bad. Grotesque. It's actually named Grotesque. I love that name. It was certainly grotesque for sure. Only 13 left. All my spike traps are just chilling here. Maybe if I'm lucky, I can just lead any other horrors to it. Pitchfork, so I did some hex cleaner. Taking the hex cleaner for sure. This door cannot be opened by us. I can actually go on top of the platform. Ooh, more horrors. Yes. These are fairly easy to kill, though. Not even sure if it'll be necessary to. Oh, it spotted me. Looks like its attacks are getting stuck on the environment, which is very pog indeed. These things do not like being set on fire. That much is true. They're also fairly dumb. So I should be able to reload in time. Oh, fuck! Took a little bit of decay damage there. Got a little careless. Is it healing itself? No way. They are healing themselves. So, if you don't kill these things immediately, well, that's gonna be a problem, isn't it? Good thing I got the mother of all eldritch abomination weapons, don't I? Scaled leather. Thankfully, we didn't take much damage that time. Not even any corruption. Bad hump. We'll take this stuff and move it a little bit closer to the entrance so we don't forget it. Unfortunate body here. This is insects. Drop the... So they should stay there, I hope. See if there are any other creepy crawlies over here that can lead to their doom. Some rancid water. Locked doors. Let's see what we got over here. Nothing on this end. At this point, I should probably think about going back and picking up all my tripwires after all. We got all these elegantly long hallways, so it'd be perfect for such traps. In fact, I will go do that really quick. Chat, give me a second. Oh, another one of those guys. We are definitely cheesing our way through this one, chat. I don't want to face that thing. Who knows what it'll do to us? Those long arms, those little tentacles. Corrupting tentacles, apparently. Part of me would love to find out what those corrupting tentacles would do to, but not in this stream. Yeah, then. Let's go. There they are. Yeah, this is the perfect place to set up an ambush. This long hallway. Poor bastard. Aren't you fully a cooked eel? Enchanting blaze blue. That's cute. Go ahead and set up our traps over here, chat. Got still got a good 10 of them or so. Now you're thinking with hotkeys. Alright. Now then, to stalk our prey. Go for the big boy first. Got you. Oh, I missed. Pretty at half health? Oh my god. Damn. You punch like a brick. Eh? Are you not gonna follow me? Come on. Bastard. Got you. Hook, line, and sinker. We'll leave those there for now, chat. We'll take out the other one, the smaller one, on our own. Easy as pie, especially with this weapon. Ah! Must have shot that in its dying breaths. Not bad. Unassuming ingenuity. This is definitely a manufacturing plant, that's for sure. Scavenger mask. You hear that? Very curious. Oh, these all appear to be drones. All right. They don't seem to be active. Just as well. I don't really want to deal with these guys right now. They are fairly annoying to fight. What is that noise? There's a bunch of unfinished rooms that are over here. Top of the oil. I have a bad feeling about this, chat. More likely than not, there's some that have escaped confinement and are active, moving around the area. Smart thing to do would be to head back and pick up my traps, but kind of lazy. Famous last words, maybe? Maybe. Strange. I haven't ran into anyone yet. Bags now overrated too. Oh. The entrance of this manufactorum was quite a ways away, chat. These are all locked up as well. Let's see what's up here first. Ah, another body. Grilled manahart base? Firestone, foremost material. Some money. My god, how high up is this? Oh. Ooh. Got another tentacle boy. Ooh, two of them. Yeah, we're gonna definitely need our traps back, chat. We also should probably dump the excess cargo we gotta go here for the time being. Gotta make room. Not gonna spoil while it's on the ground. Be fine. We will pick up this stuff later. After we deal with the unfortunate residents. The squatters, if you will. This abode. Go ahead and sprint all the way back. Even for a fantasy area with a fantasy game with lots of magic tech, I can't help but feel like these facilities are in fairly good condition for being so empty. You know, aside from being infested full of horrors. I wonder how artificial intelligence works in this universe. So different from our own. Could there be a realm where I am powered by mana, by magic, as opposed to electricity? A very interesting thought experiment. Now then, how should I go about setting the traps here? Maybe not so close to you. Now then, easy does it. ugly motherfucker. Oh, shit. Fuck. He noticed me fighting his buddy. Don't even give him a chance to recover. That worked. Do I have any scrap metal? Cool. See that. These things were truly grotesque. Love all the potions I'm grabbing off their bodies, though. Very useful. Don't have many traps left. Only two. Looks like they went to good use, though. Still need to think about possibly playing a spooky game for Halloween. But this game can be pretty spooky all on its own, can't it? Even had a few jump scares here and there. Which not all action RPGs can claim, you know? A few more buggers over there. Must be the main manufacturer. Where does this lead? Must be the bottom floor. Yep. Oh, shit. He knows that I'm here or nearby. He'll be joining your friends soon. Such an ugly motherfucker. Dead. Strange that they have all these potions, though. Take out the other one really quick. Where is he? There's two of them. We have one of these left. Ow. Damn it. Dang! The amount of damage those things do if you remain inside of them is insane. Good thing I have so many potions. We're not going to play nice with these either. Not by a long shot. Decay damage upgrade, huh? Where's your decay damage now? Oh, man. Oh man, you guys pack a punch! If I had used any ball varnish, I could probably kill you in that one single combo. I did not. Be good now, chap. We are good for now. We're all out of traps, though. Energizing Poison, temporarily reduces skill cooldowns. Oh, well, well, well. You gonna start heading to bed? Oh, have a good night. And you joined our Discord, huh? Welcome to the Discord. Make sure to read our rules and have a good time. Goodbye now. Have a nice sleep. A steep drop. Let me say hi to you on Discord. Really. One more. Looks like there's only one more horror here, chat. I wonder what this says in English. Isn't it open for you? Should be able to deal with just one of them. Do we have any bolt varnish? I thought I had some varnish rags. Was I mistaken? Or did I put them away? Ah, we have four. Okay. If we're able to catch him by the surprise, we should be able to take him out fairly quickly. Without much trauma. At least that's what I'm hoping for. Snap. A three-way combo? You've got to be joking me. Get stun locked, bitch. Got you. Fuck, man. Good thing I used the bolt varnish, huh? Bastard. Greed. It pains me to see my fancy designs put through such rapid, careless production, but at least I can be glad that, bastardized or not, my golems are saving the region. We're just about tapped out of the local iron and palladium we need to keep up production, and with the rune train rails cut off as they are, we can no longer import what we need. If we don't break the siege soon, what's left of Harmattan is finished. I've heard rumors of some powerful being emerging from Unsoon, an actual god, they say. All I can do is hope that it's true and that they send us help. Because nothing short of divine intervention is going to break the stalemate at this point. Galvanic Fist. Unlock the gate. What horrors await us now? Wonder what that says. Never seen it so up close before. Looks really nice. No, this one says Harmattan. What lurks amongst these ruined factories? Ooh, junk. These are always acceptable. They also break down these garbage items here, which is the Iron Great Hammer, or is much needed steel. Without any wood, though, I will not be able to make any arrows, much less traps. What else can be looted from this region? More bodies. A knight's corpse? What's this doing here? Coding Charmeur. That must be a French thing. I'll need to ask, or at least a French Canadian thing. I'll need to ask Lamarth about that. Dead end. Wonder what lies at the end of that red. Where does this go? Wheelbarrow? Antique Plateau. Cool. So that leads to the exit. Not bad. Not bad at all, game. Some straw hat, a blessed potion, red by seeds and star mushrooms. Bags of weight again. Figures. What lies beneath, behind here, I wonder? Drop the stuff we don't need. Azite boots. Larva eggs. We can use these to make more bolt rags, actually. So, not the worst thing. I'll take this home to sell. Need to dump the rest, though. Heavy. Guess we'll have to leave the boots as well. For now. Is this it? Missing something? Where does this go? We're back out here to the Antique Plateau. This does not look like a boss room. I do not know what a boss room is. I'm kind of afraid, though. I'm worried that something's going to pop out of me and try to kill me now. Such interesting architecture as well. Is that a giant wheel? Well, let's take a look around, chat. course. Could make a bunch of tripwires. Could give me a bunch of tripwires. What the hell is this? Give the gemstone key to a war bot of some kind. Are we really in the ruined hippodrome? Or are we in a different location entirely? Explore a bit, chat. So now I'm curious where we are. Come on, game, are you not gonna let me go up there? These things are barely, not even a shin height. I guess if there's nothing to see there, there's nothing to see, but still. Looks like I'm starving. Have a meal, shall we, chat? Where are we? Is this really a theater? What is this? Aha! So it was a theater. It's the theater's bridge. We are over there. Very good. We will have to remember to come back here. Loot the area. Azide hammer. Some interesting items. Can we enter this thing? No. That's just fine. I assume this bridge is busted then. Or is it? Huh? What the fuck? There just happens to be rope here. What time is it? 6 in the morning, apparently. What appears to be a robot fighting some mantis shrimp. At least we now know how to get here, don't we? Right then. Let's head back to town. Sell some of the stuff we found. Deposit the rest. At least we know how to get there now. If I go north from here, where are we gonna end up? Yeah, we shouldn't go north. Do some more exploration later. Let's head back to town. We need to find a way. Should be back. Another treasure chest. A lot of items in here. The game is quite generous. If we're not careful, we're gonna be too heavy again. That's no good. We must get across the river. Wonder why there's so many makeshift watchtowers around. I don't see any bandits. You see a robot dog, though. Not today, buddy. Not today. was once been a fascinating bridge, I should say. Here we'll head north. We'll come back in our explorer suit and collect as much junk as we can find. Hopefully, if I destroy these robots along the way, they will not molest me on my way back. Molesting in the non-sexual sense, I do mean in the sense of agitating my weapons, of getting in the way of progress as we know it. Skills and cooldown. We've crossed the river, must make our way northward, hopefully not get lost on the way there. Fortunately, I hold no promises because we are quite heavy right now. I could see our destination. Always good. Once we get back inside the city limits, I'm gonna go use the restroom for a short time. Just remembered, we're outside. Don't need to have this on it. And of course, shopkeeper stall is still here.
Greetings, friend.
Greetings, friend. I believe we already have a pair of brutal knuckles, so we don't need that. We're still overweight, in spite of our sails. We are much lighter now and should be able to sprint the rest of the way through. Alright, let's take a quick break, chat. I'll be right back. I am back. Did y'all miss me? Should be all we need. Okay. Probably set 4. Ancient bunker, the ruined hippodrome, and ancient turbine. Seems kind of strange they only found one gemstone key, right? It says here you have can now enter the ruins near the ancient bunker, the ruined hippodrome, and the turbine. To retrace her steps? Not the worst idea, I guess. Make ourselves a nice left turn at Albuquerque. With my luck, I might end up getting lost anyway. I have a tendency to do that. Almost a knack for it, you would say. by cash. Some wheat. This place doesn't look abandoned. I wonder if someone still lives here. Strange that there's a dead mantis shrimp here with nary a robot in sight. I can only imagine that the robo doggo hood must have went off somewhere. Why are there tents here? I still wonder why there's like watchtowers everywhere, but I don't see any human beings around. Makes me concerned. I probably shouldn't get too distracted, right? Real human beings. Oh, I'm a dumbass. I should have brought my flint and tinder with me. I always forget to do that. We're quick enough, maybe you won't need it. It's a pretty big if, though. There's really no way to get up there. No secret backstage or anything I should know about. Oh, so we can go here. Very interesting. Secrets? Kind of weird for a theater to have no backstage. They just magic their way out or something. The backstage passes for me, it seems. None that matter anyway. There's nothing over here, right? not fall to my death, thankfully. Must be windows. How many dead adventurers who came before me? Miss a spot. Glad I came back when I did. Wow. What a find. What a find. This is why we always come back, chat. You never know what you'd look find back there, find down here. Dungeon diving as we are. Here we scraped this whole place clean before we head back. It looks like we may have cleaned this factory, but I want to make sure. Every nook and cranny has to be poured over. Because we are not coming back here. Hey, Corpse Reborn. Welcome to the stream. How are you today? Ah! Thank you for the follow as well. From your name, you wouldn't happen to be the same corpse from Danger U, would you? Or a different corpse? Thank you for the follow, by the way. You're not? Okay. Welcome to the stream, though. You have now, and thank you so much for the follow. You're now, you are from Danger U, but you're a different corpse? Okay. Welcome to the stream either way. I think you've probably heard this spiel before, but you're now officially a Loli, and welcome to the Lulztime show. This is actually Vega, if you remember them. Of course I remember Vega. I thought you, I almost confused you with Corpse, who actually goes by the name Corpse on Danger U. But I haven't seen him log in a long time, so I don't know what happened to them. So what you been up to, Vega? Remember them? You used to have them added, but that was my last account. Oh, yeah. Huh? What the? Oh, this was well hidden. That was very well hidden. I didn't even notice that the first time. Been mostly trying to help out family and get my PC set up. I see. Sounds like you got stuff covered then, for the time being. Destroyed test chambers? Oh, so there is actually... I've been mostly trying... never got this far into the game. You mean into Outward? Yeah. I've been playing and streaming this game for around 100 plus hours now. This is actually part of the DLC. You didn't even know there was a DLC? Well, now you know. It's been included into the Definitive Edition by default now, but I'm still playing the original one. And I can't upgrade to the Definitive Edition without breaking my save file, and I'm not going to be redoing 100 plus hours worth of this game, so... You have to redo 100 plus hours in Fallout before and just stop playing. Yeah, that's how I feel typically. When that something like that happens to me, it could take me forever to get back to playing the game again. Just because I'm like, I'm tired. I don't want to fucking play this game anymore at that point. You have basic Outward, not without the DLC? Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, the Outward DLCs are quite generous. They pretty much give you an entire new, like, 3 or 4 new maps, an entire new campaign, all that good shit. Ah! Oh, hell no, these things actually respawned? That kind of spooks me for a second there. These are very easy to kill, though, Trogs. It took me for a second, but... Oh my god, do they all respawn? Fuck that noise. I don't want to go through this whole section again, are you fucking kidding me? No. Hey, got some free stuff though. Then again, this is not a particularly large dungeon. I could just walk all the way up to the surface, I'm sure. Big sword? Yep. I used to do sword and shield style, but now I'm doing a... two-handed style. It's quite fun. I'm just gonna walk run past the KZ bandits. I'm not gonna even bother fucking with them right now. Ain't nobody got time for your shit. Well, maybe I'll fight one of them. Oh, whoa. I'm not fighting all of you assholes together. Fuck that. For fuck's sake. So, we're gonna go back to our original plan of just going straight home instead of getting distracted by NPCs. Because I'm dumb like that. The game's probably going to teleport me somewhere far away, and it's going to be a bitch and a half to get back to. Yep, of course. Where am I now? God damn it. Thanks, Skip. I just wish you would, you know, bring me home a little bit closer to home. I remember I was lost in a desert somewhere. I should reinstall that game again. Yeah, the desert isn't even that bad, honestly. Oh, thank you for the... thank you for the hydrate redeem. Let me do that really quick. The desert is actually quite easy. Harmattan, meanwhile, is very confusing.
Greetings, friend.
Greetings, friend. Let me sell this. Draw a hat. What else here can I sell? All these cold stones, this. Actually, I take that back. I'll keep these so I can make some scaled stuff, I guess. I need to keep that too. You have the blue sand, don't need any blue sand. Don't need any of these arcane dampeners either. I remember you couldn't craft really good gear, but I never go that far. You could craft really good. Yeah, I crafted most of my gear, or most of my good gear, honestly. Even, like, this big-ass sword, I pride and joy. Alright, 339 silver, let's go! Are you selling anything good right now? You are not. Giant iron key. There we go. So you can actually yeah, mail. Scorched cocoon requires scorched cocoon. Or Greaves. Or a pistol. Extreme poison. This need. Actually, I could build this now. I think I have all these ingredients. We should try building that when we get back home. Along with the golem rapier. Yeah, I could actually just make a golem rapier now, too. I want to make the galvanic pistol, but I need some shield golem scraps, and that's a bitch. I really want to make the boozy hide back, but it just looks cute. And I would need a scaled satchel to make that, okay. How do I make scaled satchel then? Game, tell me. Primitive satchel, okay, I need a primitive satchel, I need two hides and some... I think I have all these, don't I?
Greetings, friend.
Give me back my hides. Yeah, I should actually be able to craft that now, in fact.
Greetings, friend.
Give me some cloth, my dude. I know I'm just buying back all the shit I sold you, but... So, I should be able to make primitive satchel, scaled satchel. Cool, I made a scaled satchel. Add time. Yep, I unfortunately have the... Oh, let's wait a bit. Hello. Sorry about that. I had to have the ads on in order to reduce the number of pre-roll ads which pop up. But as I was saying, I was just talking to myself when, yeah, pre-rolls basically keep people from even sticking around. But as I was saying, I was basically doing a little crafting, and made myself a nice scaled satchel, so eventually I can, when I find the cows of this universe, I can meet this cute backpack here. The Boozy backpack, if I can find where it was. This cute thing here. When I use the stream, I wish all ads could be turned off. Yeah, same. It used to be that you could just opt out of ads entirely, but now you can't even do that, so you're forced to either stream with 90-second ads for no pre-rolls, or suffer pre-rolls. The absolute state of streaming online nowadays. Oh, there's a shield golem that I need to kill later. Owned. Y'all can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread woman. Oh shit! I didn't look where I was going. Also, I don't know if you remember, but you also count as one of you if you open the stream up in browser while logged in, if you recall correctly. I think so, yeah. Helps bump you up the search engine a bit on Twitch. Oh, that's a good point. I do have SiriBot contracted. Well, not really contracted, but watching my stream. So, that always counts as one viewer. But thanks for the tip. You know what's strange? I always used to get visitors to the stream who wanted to watch outward. I wonder why it's declined. I mean, I figure part of that declined because the lockdowns are mostly over and kids went back to school, but still. Wednesdays used to be my best night. Seems like a lot less people are online now. Yeah, that's probably part of it. Which is unfortunate, but what can you do? Which is why I really appreciate everyone that stops by to hang out, you know? You always found it super hard to do a stream solo, especially if nobody's in chat. Yeah, you kind of just learn to talk to yourself after a bit. In some ways, it's not very different from when I used to stream in Discord, you know? I just sort of hang out and play a video game, or stream a video game I happen to be playing that evening. You always sort of ramble to yourself? Yeah. It seems like that's become a skill that most streamers have to do. Or learn to do, I should say. I had to stop myself from making weird noises. Believe it or not, some people find those weird noises endearing. A lot of streamers that I watch now have these little quirks that set them apart from each other.
You better have the money.
I better have the money. Shut the fuck up, guy. When comfortable, I sound like a goblin. That sounds so adorable. Dancer mask. I was able to make it home with all my spoils. I really like this person's outfit.
Ah, good day.
I'm the good friend.
What do you need?
I guess this person wouldn't sell boozy hide, would they?
Need something?
Can I help you?
Did I not sell hide here anymore? Weird.
You better have the money.
A wolf plate armor. One of the heaviest armors in the game. Tempting, but eh. Oh?
You better have the money.
Ready, go. Ready, goes.
How can I help you?
Remember there were SAR weapons? I think there are. Not sure where they are, though. At least I haven't seen them around yet. Go ahead and buy all these potions. Potion recipes. Even if I never use them, it's just good to have them. How does the stream closed caption thing work? Stream closed caption is currently not active because I have to open up a website browser to turn it on. So I actually don't have it active right now. There's another closed caption system that I found that might not require using a freaking external website to work. So I'll test that out later, but for now, the closed caption that you're looking at actually does not work. I remember checking one on my stream, but it charged be used? What do you mean, charged be used? Oh, you mean it charges to use? That's dumb. There's a lot. There's some free ones out there now, so I don't even bother. I'm not going to bother with anything if it costs money. I mean, what's the point? Yeah. Like, the settings for it had options for it to cost money to enable. Oh, that's really fucking dumb. I didn't see settings like that when I was looking through it, so maybe it's changed. No! Oh well. Let's see here. What can we build now? We can make a Scourge Cocoon, but... do that. You found the app on someone else's stream and they had it set up for bits? Oh, I see. So you could set it up where you can charge people for it. That's still kind of dumb. I'm not going to charge people just to use a closed caption system. It just seems unethical. Did I sell all my... Where the hell is all my... What happened to all my mats? I could have sworn I put them all away here. Did I sell all of them? Am I that dumb? Bro, real... Oh, here they are. Shit, I'm stupid. They were just hiding in plain sight. I was about to morb. Does add rid of mod support? It does. It does. Good question. Horror pistol. I don't have any installed right now, but it does in fact have mod support. Hell yeah. Two new weapons, a horror pistol, which inflicts extreme poison, and a golem rapier. Oh my god. Does the golem rapier count as a two-handed weapon? It does, because it's so fucking huge. 39 damage. And it's fast as fuck compared to my Goldwitch Clinic. That's funny. There are mods for co-op, yeah. This thing has really long reach. 39 damage. Sick. But I like my Gold Lich Claymore. I crafted both of these, though. Oh, it's not as easy to set up. That's a bummer. Guess I have to put away one of these weapons to slide in my horror pistol. I shall put away one of my obsidians. Risk rain, only a host needs some mods. Oh yeah. That's unfortunate. Scrap is required. Well, I'm fresh out of scrap. I guess I'll just have to scrap my plans. That was bad. Risk Green 2. You know, I hear a lot of good things about Risk Green 2. Gonna lurk for a bit and go bother people on VRC. Alright, no problem. Actually, I'm just gonna be streaming for around 10 minutes more. I usually stream an average of 3 hours a night. Then I'm gonna go do some training in Underknife and Birth with another VTuber. We have a tournament we're going to be going to on Friday. I will not be streaming tonight's training session because my sleeping schedule has gone to shit and I really need to spend more time. I really need to go to sleep earlier. That being said, this is probably a good time to end this particular run through of tonight's game of Outward. Anyway. I usually end after completing a dungeon and successfully getting back home. It looks like we've only died twice in this run through, which is pretty good. Yula, nice to catch on your streams. Likewise, thank you so much for coming to one of my streams. If you stick around just a couple more minutes, we can raid and you can get some free points. But you don't need to, it's entirely optional. Have fun in VR chat, by the way. Oh, okay. So, who are we going to raid tonight? Exactly. It's kind of a bummer that there weren't many people who stuck around tonight, but a few people did show up earlier in the stream. So, no big deal. Junie is pretty cool fanboy. They're playing Parasite Eve tonight, and I don't remember the last time we got to raid one of their streams.
In the world.
We can go visit them.
Dinosaurs.
Thanks again for stopping by, Vega. Are we gonna fight, like, nice seeing you again after so many months. Let's see now.
Please tell me.
Raid. Junie.
But yeah, if you ever want a good Y2K ambience demo,
you're on Discord like normal? Yep.
Great, especially PS1 demo disc.
If you like, I can invite you to our Discord, or the Discord for my stream, or for my VTuber stuff.
A lot of like demo discs had like amazing music. Which one is the one that I remember the most? Hold on.
Let me do this.
There's a demo.
So that's the link to our Discord. And as for our raid message tonight, we're just going to do something basic. Lulz raid. Nothing too big.
Let's see which one I see here. Is there
and we're going to go ahead and raid now, and I'll see you soon.
I want somebody to tell me what. Like. Yeah. Hey! Hey, y'all! Lulztime! Lulz raid! How you doing? Yo, how's it going, Corpse Reborn? welcome, everybody! How you doing? Hi, Lulz. Welcome in. I hope you're doing well. How's your stream? Let's see what you're doing. Gotta like, I gotta shook right now. You're playing Outward! Isn't that... Wait, I heard this one before. Right? I heard this one before. Isn't that or that? Yeah. Yeah, I heard of this. Of course. No VTuber fucking talks about this game all the time. It was comfy night. Not many people.